Hey guys, it's Steve from Tactical U Firearms Training and Self-Defense. Today we're going to talk about grip and how to actually draw the gun from the holster to get an appropriate grip. And while we're talking about grip, we're going to teach you how to better grip the gun so that your support side hand doesn't jump off the gun and that you're able to mitigate recoil. So why don't we jump right in and get started. First off, if you look at how somebody grabs their pistol off the side from a 3 o'clock or 9 o'clock position, usually their elbows out to the side. And unfortunately, if we do that, if we pay attention to the joints, when I'm out to the side like this and I bring my firearm out, you'll notice my elbow is higher than my wrist. So if my line of sight is a straight trajectory to my target, what happens is I literally have to swing the gun up into play. That's not a duplicatable process. I want to show you a better way. Instead of leaving your elbow out to the side, you want to take these two bones and you want to square them up about back behind the receiver of the gun. If I take my elbow and I roll it in so that it's in line with my shoulder and my wrist, now what happens when I take the firearm out, notice where my elbow is. It's in pretty much the same level position as my pistol. Now I can push it out in front of my target and it goes straight out to target. I'll show you this again. Here's the incorrect way to do it. Elbow's chicken winged out to the side. Notice my elbow's higher than my wrist. I gotta swing my wrist up into my line of sight. If I roll my elbow in and make everything in a straight line, when I come out, it pushes up right out in front of my line of sight. So this is the first step in order to get a good grip on the gun. Now we're gonna talk about the grip. This is where a lot of people fail. People think they have a good grip, but the problem is their support hand jumps off the gun, so they tend to over-grip the pistol. I'm going to show you this from a couple of different angles. So if I have a good grip on the gun, first and foremost, if you'll notice, my hand is straight behind the receiver. If I grab the poor grip, my hand's not straight behind the receiver. But if my hand's straight behind the receiver, that's where it starts. Let's talk about where the recoil happens with the pistol. It's at the top and the rear of the gun. When the gun fires, it cycles to the rear. And if you notice, the muzzle popped up when I did that. If you have a poor grip on the gun is going to flip. So what we want to do is we want to get high up and tight behind the receiver, just like we were on a baseball bat or choking up on a golf club. Simultaneously, I want you to notice where this thumb is. When most people grab their pistol, their thumb is down here. And then when they bring their support hand into play, they get a poor grip on the gun. Okay? This thumb does not own this, we'll call it real estate. You want to get this thumb up and out of the way. This way, when I get a perch on the gun, I can get my hand up much higher. Now here's what's interesting. If my bones are over here to the side, you'll notice there's not a whole lot of ledge. If my bones are square behind the back of the pistol, this is where they were, this is where they should be, you'll notice I make a ledge right here. This ledge is a perfect pocket where I can fit my other hand into that piece of the receiver right here. Now I'm going to show you something that everyone messes up. I'm not sure why, because we explain it in detail. If I were to get a grip on the gun, most people get a grip like this, and they think they have a good grip. But I want you to pay attention to where my thumb is in relation to this bone. Here's the problem with this. If I go to pull this slide, the gun comes right out of my hand. I'm going to show you that again. People think they've got a good grip on the gun, but notice where this bone is, okay? If I squeeze the gun to the point where my hand starts shaking and my hand starts turning a different color, I still can't hold on to it. So think about that. If you have a poor grip on the gun, your hand's going to jump off the gun, and that's what happens to a lot of people. So what we want to do to fix that is I want to take this bone and I want to press it out straight. I literally want to ride the frame rail right here completely in line with my slide. Now what does this do? Let me show you. Now I can grab that slide and pull it all day. If I drop that bone ever so subtly, it comes right out of my hand. So just the extra volume and the extra friction, because I have more hand on more of the gun, up higher where its recoil access point is, it makes the gun a lot more stable. Now here's the other problem people run into. They'll get a good grip with a nice straight hand, but I want you to notice my hands are basically straight on the gun. And if I do this up here, my hand's straight on the gun, I have some space in the back here. There's a void right here, path of least resistance. So check this out. If my arm and elbow are straight, and I've got this nice straight grip like we're supposed to have, the gun still moves in my hand. Simultaneously, if my index finger isn't locked in here, or it's out in front here, the gun moves this way. So now I have 2 points where the gun's moving. But what I want you to notice is, if I take my wrist, and I don't go all the way out to target, I shorten up my grip, and I pancake the rear with this bone tall, notice where I'm putting pressure into the gun. And notice my wrist is broken. So if you watch my left elbow, I'm literally going to turn it up a little bit with a broken wrist. Here, I'll do this up here so you can see it. Right here. And if you notice what I have here, my wrist is broken. Again, it's not straight, it's broken. And if my wrist is bent and broken like that, I have no void in here. And you can see that from right here, as opposed to this. Okay? So this will get the gun rocking out of my hand. This will get the gun nice and stable in my hand. So, the last piece of this is when everybody throws the gun out straight, they have a core grip, they have this fulcrum of weight out in front of them, and what happens is when they recoil, the gun jumps out of their hand, and they have to readjust, and their whole body and torso moves. What I want to do is shorten up my grip, put pressure high and tight, get this bone nice and straight, and watch what happens when I roll my elbow up. See the pressure it puts right there? So the moral of the story is, I don't have to death grip the gun to make the shot. All I have to do is use my bones correctly so that it actually supports the gun to the rear and where the access point of the recoil is. So if I do this also, when the gun fires, the recoil will mitigate through my wrist and elbow, as opposed to like a single unit that just is a fulcrum of weight out in front of me.
So again, bones high. Pancake this grip so that I've got a broken wrist. My elbow comes up, all right? I want you to watch the gun.
Take a look at that. That's what we're talking about, okay? So it's about controlling the trigger, seeing that sight picture as it comes back and levels down, but you can't fire into the recoil. You fire into the recoil, it's all over the place. This little tip will help you tremendously. You should try it out.